Hi, my name is Jenny and I'm a mind and body coach, and welcome back to my 30-day challenge. Today we're back with Pilates. So if you want to stop and forget cracking straight away. So you start with your feet together and then toe heel or heel toe them apart to give you your hip distance. This is probably less than you think. You want to think your feet are directly under your hip bones. We're just start off just gently rocking your pelvis back and forward. So you're doing an anterior tilt, posterior tilt. So you're going back and forward. And then settling into your neutral, so that midpoint. Just roll your shoulders back a couple of times. And then we'll start coming to the breath. So nice deep inhale through the nose. Exhale through pursed lip. So just imagine you're blowing out row candles. So try to send your breath down into the lower lobes of the lungs. Rather than breathing into your shoulders, send the breath nice and deep. We tend to breathe this shallow breath into our upper chest. And it actually, switches on your sympathetic nervous system, which is our kind of fight or flight, it's our stress place. So we want to send it into our parasympathetic by doing that deep, diaphragmatic breath. So now as you exhale, start engaging pelvic floor. So just imagine you're trying to stop yourself going to the toilet. Just 20%. Gently engaging, inhale fully. And then transverses, those lower deep abdominals. So if you bring your hands between your hip bones. As you exhale, feel it tightening under your fingers. Bringing the hands back to the side. We're going to do some roll downs to mobilize through our spine. So inhale at the top. As you exhale, chin to chest, just slowly peeling down, upper back, middle back, lower back. Let the weight of the head pull you down. We're just going to hang here for a couple of breaths. You can have your knees slightly bent. Still engaging pelvic floor transversus. Protect your lower back. Then on the next exhale, slowly rolling up. Lower back, middle back, upper back. Vertebrae all the way up. Inhale at the top, then again, exhale, chin to chest, slowly peeling down. All the way. We'll go straight up on the exhale. So slowly roll it up, and then head comes up last. One more. Inhale at the top, and then exhale. Peeling down, scooping up your stomach muscles. And then slowly roll all the way up. So we're going to come straight down to the mat. So lying on your back. So just start rocking your pelvis backward and forward. And then find your neutral. So hip bones, pubic bones are parallel. You've got your natural curve in the lower back. We start off just straightening your right leg, flexing the foot so you're engaging through your leg. And then you can either have both hands behind the head or one arm slightly to the side. As you exhale, you're peeling yourself up across to your left knee, staying in neutral. Exhale, drawing up. Inhale, coming down. If you want to make it a little bit harder, let's hover that foot just up. Exhale, coming up. Inhale, coming down. And again. Keeping the pelvis completely still. Time five more. Pelvic floor transversus engaged. Last three. Keeping the elbows wide. Last two. Or on the next one, you're going to stay at the top. Exhale up an inch, inhale down an inch. A little move right at the top. The through last five. Four. Stay up. Three. Two. Last one. And come down. Bending your right knee and straightening your left again, staying in neutral. So again, option to hover the foot. If you did it on the other side, let's go for it. Exhale up, inhale to come down. Just a little peeling yourself across the side. Five more. And four. Just look to the knee. And
And step top, exhale up and in, inhale lunge. Little squeeze at the top. Last, five, four, three, two,
and come down. And just massage out your stomach muscles. We're gonna do some hip rolls. This is to mobilize through your spine. So inhale at the bottom, exhale slowly up, lower back, middle back, upper back, just to a straight line. Inhale at the top, exhale, upper back, middle back, lower back. Three imprint to neutral. And again, slowly rolling up. Trying to find as much movement through your spine as you can, nice and controlled. Peeling up. Find a point that's a little bit stiffer, try to go slower over that point. And slowly rolling up. You can lift your heels at the top just to make a little bit more space as you roll down. Replace the heels to roll up. Just working slowly and controlled with your breath. So it's exhale to roll up. Inhale at the top and then exhale all the way down. Slowly rolling up. And all the way down. Coming back to center. So coming back to your neutral. We're going to come to imprint. As you exhale, engaging your stomach muscles to create a slight tilt in the pelvis. Everything's active here, so you're not just pressing it back down. Inhale to neutral. Exhale, engage. Tightly zipping up through your waist. Inhale to neutral. Exhale. And then we're going to keep our imprint. Bring your legs up into tabletop. And then we're going to come into toe taps. As you exhale, hover one foot just off the floor. Inhale, bring it back in, and then change. So you're pulling your stomach muscles in nice and flat. Use the exhale as you take the leg away. Using the breath. So you want the other knee, make sure it doesn't creep in towards you. Still just going side to side. Couple more. And then come back to center. Interlace your hand behind your head. You're going to flex up and stay up. And this time, exhale, take your leg out to the side. Inhale to center. And then exhale to the other side. Watch your hip bone doesn't lift. However, stays completely still. Flexing up. Relaxing your head into your hand. Working into your obliques. Hold it here. Try to get your elbows open and relax your head into your hands. Can you go up a little bit higher? One more each side. And then bring your head down, releasing your hands, releasing your feet. And then we're going to roll onto our sides. So making a little pillow with the bottom arm. Lift together. So you lift it up to the underside of the waist. So what we're going to do, you can have your hand under the knee too. Make sure you don't collapse down here. We're going to hover both feet up off the mat. We're going to do a little Charlie Chaplin there. So you're going to rotate out, coming back in. Rotate out, still lifting out to the underside of your waist. Just try to twist and open your legs. Five more. And then point your toes, you're going to do a little crisscross. Bring one foot in front, back on the other side. So you're balancing here, lifting up to your waist still. So just going side to side, balancing on your hip. If you need to, you can put your hand down for support. Last four, three, two, and one. And we'll go on to the other side. So again, make a little pillow with the arm.
Body straight, lifting out through your waist, lifting through the underside, lifting both legs, and then rotate out and in, out and in. Zipping up your waist to keep your balance. Five more. Okay, point toes, a little crisscross. So bring the leg on the underside up, still lifting out through your waist. The higher you lift your legs, the harder it will be. Last four, last three, two, and one.
Lying on your front. Legs slightly apart, makes a little bit more space for your back. Hands to the side. So you're going to inhale, pulling your shoulders back. Exhale, rolling up, just looking ever so slightly forward. Keep the leg through your back of your neck. Inhale to stay, exhale back down. Inhale, shoulders, exhale, rolling up. Inhale to stay, exhale back down. So pulling in your stomach muscles to protect your lower back. So we're trying to articulate and move through our spine here. So you can stay with that version. Bring your arms onto the body, inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale to lower. Still engaging your stomach muscles, lifting them up off the mat. Inhale, lift and lengthen. So really reach your fingers to your toes to pull your shoulders back. Let's get a couple more of these and strengthening the back side of the body. Last one. Make a little pillow with hands. You're going to bring your legs into lateral rotation. So it's sort of like frog legs that come out to the side. We're going to single leg extension first. If you've got sciatica, so a sort of shooting pain down your leg, do this with parallel leg.
Otherwise, exhale, lift and lengthen. Inhale, bring it down. Exhale, lift and lengthen. Keep the legs super straight. Point through the toe. Lift and lengthen. One at a time. So if you can either stick with the singles, or we're going to give a double. Squeeze and lift. Stomach muscles tight. So squeezing your bum to lift the legs. And then we're going to lift both legs and do a little tap. So tapping your heels together. Keep lengthening through your legs. Squeeze and lift. So last, five, four, three, two, and relax.
Press back onto your heels, coming to a shell stretch. Rounding over, just releasing any tension through your spine. Stimulating your stomach muscles. And then slowly rolling up vertebrae by vertebrae. So to counteract the extension, we're going to come into half rollback. Feet flat on the floor. Hip distance apart. Arms up at shoulder height. As you exhale, rolling your hip bones away from your thighs, scooping out your stomach muscles. Inhale, coming forward. Exhale, rolling back. Inhale, coming forward. Use the breath, pulling in your belly button. Good. So you're just coming kind of the top of your pelvis here. Don't have to go too far down. So we're going to come into oblique rollback. Options. Sitting up tall, rolling back, scooping out the stomach, eyeline pulling hand, coming up tall. Or we're going to hold it back, twist and look back to center, twist and look. So your choice, either doing the first one where you come out of it and then come back up, or you're holding the scoop and then really twisting from the waist to look underneath the armpit. The more you can twist, the better. So four, three, two, last one. And then we're going to roll down as slowly as you can. Excellent. I'm just going to shimmy down the mat. So we're going to come into a glute bridge now. So we're going to come up and down, starting in neutral. Exhale, snap your hips up and down. Exhale, up and down. So squeeze your bum before you come up. Helps get your glutes active. And then we're going to stay at the top. So you can start off, you can just start by lifting one heel, place it down. Lifting one, place it down. Or you can go for peeling the foot up, keeping your hips where they are,
Lift it up and down. So inhale up, exhale down. So either stay with this march, or we're going to come into one leg circle in a bridge. So lifting one leg up, keeping your pelvis completely still, we're going to circle legs in out of the centre, exhale, complete the circle. Keeping everything else completely still. And then the other way. Inhale over the centre leg, exhale, complete the circle for 2, 3, 4, 5. Place your foot down. If you need to come down and then come up again, then you can, otherwise it's straight in. Inhale over the centre leg, exhale, complete the circle. Other way. Place your foot down, coming all the way down. Roll over, correct. Crossing your ankles over, so your knees are quite wide. As you exhale, peeling your tailbone up, releasing your lower back. Think about pulling pubic bone to belly button. Exhale, peeling up. Inhale, release. So you're really pulling it in. So no momentum, without using your arms, you can bring them behind if you're starting to get tempted to press in. Exhale, peeling up. Inhale, release. And then crossing your hands over the other way. Two more. I love this exercise. It really gets the lower abdominals. Last one. And then we're going to go into the full roll-up. Straighten your legs, flex your feet. You're going to bring your arms to your ears, but keeping your ribs pulled in. Active legs. Inhale, hands to ceiling. Then exhale, slowly peeling up vertebrae by vertebrae. You can put your hands into your thighs to help you up. Inhale to start coming back. Exhale, slowly rolling down. Inhale, hands to ceiling. Exhale, slowly peeling up. Inhale to start coming back. Exhale, slowly rolling back down. And again. So you're using the exhale on the tricky part of the move. The more you engage your legs, the less your feet will fly up in the air. Last one. So come into line on your front again. We're going to use swan dive. So again, if you've got sciatica, you don't want to do a lateral rotation with your legs. So just do the breaststroke prep we did before, the extension like this. Otherwise, you're going to have your legs wide and turned out. So first of all, you inhale, pull your shoulders back. Exhale, come up onto just on the elbows. Inhale to stay, exhale, back down. Inhale, shoulders, exhale, coming up. Inhale to stay, exhale, back down. So then if your back's feeling warm, you can start to extend the arms. But here, you're pressing down your pubic bone and lifting your hip bones up. You shouldn't feel this in your lower back at all. You're lengthening up. If you've got any lower back issues, again, do the inversion from before, don't do this, or just stay on your elbows. Inhale the top and then exhale, pulling yourself down. Inhale shoulders, exhale, coming up, extending, squeezing your glutes. Inhale to stay, exhale back down. Inhale shoulders, exhale, extending up. Really opening across your shoulder, collarbones here. Inhale the top and then pulling yourself down slowly. So you can stick with this, and you come into the slow rock. So you're slowly lowering yourself down, keeping that position, pressing yourself up. So you're really squeezing all the extensors, the back side of the body, to maintain that position. Exhale forward. Last one. Coming up. Inhale the top and slowly coming down. Again, sit back onto your heels, coming into a shell stretch, rounding over. And then slowly rolling up. So we're going to come into a lateral flexion. So we don't really do it now, sort of side to side. Lying on your side, arm extended, other arm on top. We're going to lift everything at once. So you're going to lift up, legs come up, upper body up, and then down. So lifting up, coming down. Exhale. So watch a little bit of a wobble. So coming up and down. So you're trying to pull the arm back as you come up.
Five more. Four. Try not to do that. Three. Two. Last one. And then the other side. This mat's also quite uncomfortable on the hip bone. Doesn't help the movement. Right, so on the side. So lifting up and down. So you're trying to lift everything at once. Two more. Last one. And then I'll move the front again. Making a little pillow with the hands. You just single leg extension with the leg straight.
You can do another round if this is what you did before. So exhale, lift and lengthen. Inhale down. Stomach muscles pulled in. Reaching through your toes. So you're trying to lift the leg as high as you can, but keeping your hip bone pressed down into the mat. So again, if this isn't okay, you can lift both legs and bring it down. Lift up and down. And then if you want to, if you're with me, you can lift everything and kick back and forth. So it's inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two. Three, four, five, exhale, two, three, four, five, last inhale, two, three, five, exhale, two, three, four, five, lift and hold, and lower. Again, press back onto your heels. Round through your spine. And then slowly rolling up. Coming to lie on your back again. Teasers. We'll start off at one level and then we'll progress it as we go. So it's inhale, reaching your hands up. Exhale, coming up, hold this position. Inhale, arms by ears, exhale to lower. Inhale, arms up, exhale, coming up. Inhale, arms by ears, exhale to lower. So this might be enough for you. If you can come all the way up without using any momentum, it's inhale, hands up. Exhale, feeling all the way up. Inhale, arms up, exhale, slowly rolling back down. So it's inhale, hands to ceiling. Exhale, slowly peeling up. Inhale, arms up, exhale, slowly over there. So you can stick with that up or come legs into table. Inhale, hands to ceiling. Exhale, peeling yourself up. Inhale, arms by ears. Exhale, slowly rolling back down. Inhale, hands to ceiling. So join in whichever version you're doing. Inhale, hands to ceiling. Exhale, coming up. Inhale, arms by ears. Exhale to lower. Balancing on the sit bones if you can. Just a couple more. These start to burn very quickly. Peeling yourself up. Last one. And then just hugging it into your chest. Whew. Right, we're going to come back onto hands and knees. So hands underneath shoulders, knees underneath hips. We're going to straighten one leg, lift up. And we're going to bend and straighten the leg. Engage through your stomach muscles. So using glutes to hold it there, hands free to bend and straighten the leg. Last time, four, three, two, last one, and then change. So straighten the other leg, lift up and bend and straighten. Press the floor away to lift up the shoulder blades. So peeling the leg in. Options.
start in neutral and stay in neutral.
Reaching up and then pumping the arms. Or you can come to your imprint, coming up, pumping the arms. Or we can take the legs onto the parallel. So either way, you don't want to feel this in your lower back. So we're doing 100 pumps. If you feel like your neck gets tired, you can put your hand behind your head. So whichever option you're coming into, coming up, ready, and inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. And exhale. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Halfway. 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Last inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. And calm down.
Excellent. So just hug your right knee to the chest. Straighten your left. Relax your right foot, but you can flex the left. And just slide it to the side, just hug it. Each exhale, just trying to draw in a little bit more. It's a well-deserved stretch after that. And then you can put your right foot on the left knee, or whichever side you did do. Opposite shoulder down, hand on the knee, and then just go for a gentle twist. Without pulling on the knee, just looking over the shoulder. Just wherever the knee comes, it doesn't matter. A gentle final twist. Just make sure the opposite shoulder's down. And then back to centre. Little pull in for one breath. And then extend the leg. Bringing in the upper side. So again, flex this foot, relax this one, slightly side, hugging it in. It's exhale, drawing in a little bit more. Just enjoying the stretch. And then again, foot on the knee, little twist, looking over the shoulder. So one side might be different to the other, just work with where you are. Don't pull on the knee, just be gentle. And then back to centre, pull the knee in again. Then hugging both knees and shins, you can just rock side to side. And then rolling to the side, gently pressing yourself up. I hope you enjoyed that, another Pilates workout. Comment below, let me know what you thought. If there's any exercises you want me to do next time, I will try and guide. Otherwise, I will be back tomorrow for another workout, I expect.